In this video, we are going to discuss four conditions of existence of Laplace transform. Up to now, in the last few classes, we discussed about introduction of Laplace transform and relation between Laplace and Fourier and inverse Laplace transform. In this class, we are going to discuss the existence of Laplace transform, that means conditions for the existence of Laplace transform. Same topic we discussed earlier for Fourier transforms also, conditions for existence of Fourier transforms. Those conditions are said to be Dirichlet conditions. Same three Dirichlet conditions so we will apply for the signal to get Laplace transform. If a signal is satisfying that condition, then only we can say Laplace transform is applicable for that signal. So here these are the three important Dirichlet conditions. Dirichlet conditions are used to define the existence of Laplace transform similar to Fourier. So that conditions are, the signal must be absolutely integrable in the given interval of time. In the given interval of time, in the given time slot from which to which the signal is occurring, that means from where to where we are calculating the signal, in that particular instant of the time, the signal must be absolutely integrable. That means if you consider integration minus infinity to infinity modulus of f of t dt, that must be less than infinity. That means you need to get a finite value for this integration. If you are getting infinite values, then you can say the signal is violating first Dirichlet condition and we can't represent in frequency domain by using Laplace transform. So here we are having another condition of Dirichlet to search for the existence of Laplace transform. Here that condition is, the signal or function should have finite number of maxima and minima. So what is meant by maxima and minima means, for example, you are having a signal like this. This is the maximum amplitude noticed by the signal and this is the minimum amplitude noticed by the signal. This maximum is 2 volts and this one is minus 2 volts. So 2 volts is the maximum amplitude of your signal and minus 2 volts will be minima of your signal, minimum amplitude of your signal. For example, your signal is like this, it's having like this. It's having 2 minima and 2 maxima. So first here you are having one minima, one maxima, and here you are having another maxima, and here you are having one minima, and here you are having another minima. So if you are having finite number of maxima and minima, you can trace the signal and you can define by using a particular mathematical relation and you can substitute in that Laplace transform or anything. Practically also, you can trace the signal and you can represent in spectrum. Whenever your signal is not having finite number of maxima and minima, it will show like up and downs. That means you can't judge your signal with a particular mathematical relation. You can't define your signal with a particular mathematical relation, then you will get problem. You are not going to represent with a spectrum. So here this is the problem. When you are having finite minimum number of maxima and minima, then only you can represent your signal perfectly by using Laplace transform into frequency domain. This is one condition of Dirichlet for the existence of Laplace transform. Coming to last condition, so there must be finite number of discontinuities in the signal in the given interval of time. In the given interval of time, if you are asked to find out Laplace transform, then you need to search for this condition. That means in your given interval of time, if your signal is not having finite discontinuities, your signal is discontinuing for infinite number of times. Infinite number of times your signal is discontinuing means it's going to loss. That means you are not going to represent the exact spectrum or frequency domain of the signal by using Laplace transform. So that's why in the given instant of time, in the given interval of time, your signal must have or your signal can have finite number of discontinuities. If you are having finite number or minimum number of discontinuities, there won't be much losses for that signal, and you can trace the Laplace transform. That means you can trace the spectrum of the signal. Your signal is discontinuing for every interval of time. That means for regular interval of time, your signal is losing or you are not getting your signal. Means how we can represent in spectrum, how we can represent in frequency domain. There you will get the problem. That is only the meaning of this condition. So, totally we are having three conditions. Whatever we use it for Fourier transform, that means Dirichlet conditions to say the existence of Fourier transform, same Dirichlet conditions we are using here to judge the existence of Laplace transform. So, a signal must be absolutely integrable, that means that need to satisfy this formula. A signal must have finite number of discontinuities and finite number of maxima and minima. These are nothing but conditions for existence of Laplace transform and also called as Dirichlet conditions for existence of Laplace transform.